Hello and welcome, I'm Arumba, thank you for joining me. Let's play some more Hearts of Iron 4 as Mexico. We have 14 military factories, and we estimate that the United States has between 14 and 17. So we almost have as much military capacity right now as the United States does. But they, I believe, are still on... Yeah, they haven't even finished the Giant Wakes, so they're still on isolation. So they have horrible penalties to pretty much everything. We just have to win a few of these fights. Let's grab these guys up to here. And these five. What are you doing? Are you actually attacking? You are support attacking. Okay. Let's push you guys in this way. We'll take one of these guys up to here. We'll take another three over to there. And beyond that. We actually see what type of brigades those are? Garrison brigades, yeah. Pretty weak. Looks like he's not going to cross the strait. Again, I don't think we actually have the technology to do naval invasions. Yeah, we don't. We got to research 143 days. So to end the war with Panama, I've got to either cross this damn strait, or... Oh, he landed already, you bastard! How did you land so freaking fast? Like, how did you do that? I don't understand. That's 8 brigades. Like, how did you plan that? Because he had it planned before the war started. That must be what he did. Still, the garrison brigades. Alright, we're still on rebase move. Training time is over. As far as I'm concerned. Alright. And we're gonna have to activate the plan, wherever people think that they're good. Inferior enemy. Fine, go for it. Purple, you are the... Sure, go for it. Be as aggressive as you can. Expand that line. Do whatever you want, I don't care. World tension's very high. He's ended up with 7 divisions here. He's trying to take over another one of my provinces. Alright, well. Let's tell you to be aggressive too. And let's have you march into there. And he did advance forward, which is good. That's 3 divisions we can kill. Or at least get out of experience, Is he seriously doing, like, that well against us? What the hell? Attacking from multiple directions, yes. Terrain is bad. Tactic damage. So they're winning this tactics game. Alright, well, let's try again. Maybe this time we get a better tactic? Tactic has been countered yet again. How dare you? Counterattack. So what if I just, like, keep doing this over and over again? Will you continuously, like, change tactics? Yeah, we got a 5% versus delay. Tactics movement. Attacker tactic damage. Defender tactic damage. Alright, well. Let's change this to a front line now that he's advanced. Let's have everyone join the front line and create a front line battle plan to Panama. And he doesn't feel like he can win, but let's just see how he does for a little bit. It's kind of annoying. I did not expect them to plan that naval invasion before the war. This guy says that he's got an inferior enemy, so we'll let him prove it. Okay. We got some guys pushing forward here. The cavalry are finally crossing. The motorized are kind of done. Just deploy them now, for Christ's sake. I mean, let's put an orange. Just get up there. I just need your speed. I don't care about your training. Okay, orange is not told to attack yet, but this pink guy is immediately attacking, so that's actually good. Orange, I guess you can help out as well. Don't tell me you stopped reboots. No, I want you to strategically redeploy, excuse me. What's your defense value? 119, that's pretty good. I get the impression that this combat's gonna go on for a long time. So all these guys are suffering a penalty. How about these guys? Is it all of them that are suffering that jungle penalty? The terrain penalty? Jungle plains. They're all suffering that penalty. Interesting. Okay, stop your attack. Let's leave one behind, and let's have 9 attack from over here. Oh, actually, if you're gonna... What are you doing? You're attacking me with... That's really dumb. Yeah, let's throw these guys over here. It's nice that the AI is so kind, and they'll just automatically counterattack you if you attack them. Okay, Cav, move forward. Motorized. You need to thin your line over here. And, Motorized is actually saying that he can do it, so let's give him a commander. Whenever possible, I don't even care. Just rebase, get up there, spend your organization to get to the front line. We're holding the line over there. They're not taking over that coast. This is really irritating, but I think we'll be okay. According to this, we're going to lose, but it's going to take 28 days. We've got tons of time to reinforce it. According to this, this one's going to take a long time, too. Are we actually all fully in here? Apparently, our combat width is only 40 right now. Enemy has air superiority. River crossing terrain, weather night. 3.9% damage with a level 1 skill guy. Cool. Not very good. Can we get more... Probably Doctrine is just something good to invest in the long run. We actually do have some extra towed artillery, so I'm going to change over a couple of these guys to the one that uses that, and up here. You guys have enough experience that you can handle a change without losing a rank, I think. Got plenty of manpower. We got most of them enacting their plan. You are the only one that doesn't think you can win. That's okay. Yeah, I think we, for the most part, we just keep on advancing this line, and we allow the AI to be aggressive. But I can't let the cavalry, like, take over territory. They're not good at it. In fact, I don't want you acting on your plan. I want to manually use the cavalry army, like, the whole thing, to just control territory and try to do encirclements. That is the entire reason that we have them. So let's just delete your front line. You don't even need a combat bonus. It doesn't even matter. You have no orders assigned. I don't even care. Alright, if you're going to attack me from there, we will hold you there and pull you forward. Make it a little bit wider. You're gonna hold that line just fine. We got an encirclement on you. Good stuff. Got a little bit of defense here. Two divisions got assigned to defend that. Cool. We gotta go up the east coast as fast as we can now. A cav are tied up right now. Okay, how are we doing on the other fronts? You're defending, you're holding, you're doing fine. Again, this fight's gonna take forever. Let's hold and then relocate over to here. He's actually put a lot of divisions down here. So let's take two of them to here, one of them to here. He says he's, well, he thought he had an advantage. Don't activate your plan then. You activate your plan. If he's pulled his troops off this line, we can take Panama. That'd be awesome. Are you gonna let me do it? Are you gonna let me end this war with Panama? Then I can pull 10 troops, 10 divisions from the south up. I think that he's gonna do it, so I'm gonna go ahead and justify a war goal on you. Only takes 30 days. One more quick conquest, won't take very long. You guys get assigned to purple. We've met some resistance up here. Again, your goal though is to take territory, so that's it. Got quite a few of them support attacking this engagement here. Still only 48 combat width. I'm gonna manually tell them to stop their attack. We're at 76%, and they have done their alliance. Alright, who's doing this attack now? Hold for a second. Just hold for 1 second. Let's grab these 8. Engage, 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 engage. We don't need you to engage, just... Fresh engagement means we'll immediately go up to 96 combat width. Which sounds pretty good. Okay, this cav is, gonna keep on trying to encircle. And he immediately ends up defending himself. It's fine. Less than a day. Okay, so those guys are done. We've got 2 divisions assigned to this. I might be, like, manually microing this a little bit too much. Awesome. 79% world tension. Okay. We're done down here. For now, let's have you guys come up here. This guy, I think, was actually... Are you a good commander? I can't remember. Level 2 now. Okay. It's not bad. Could be better. Still doesn't feel very prepared. Well, part of that is because I just gave him more divisions. They're not in position. Okay. You're going to take over that province. We'll have San Antonio. Your support attacking. That's cool. You move here. We are defending here. See if we can get you to come help him. I think pink has too wide of a front line right now. Let's pull it back a little bit and pull purple over to here. You're not confident in your plan, then stop. You are now confident in your plan. Looks like this side has maybe weakened a bit. They've pulled back. Good stuff. You're waiting on relocations, and pink feels like he's extended too much. It's fine. Just press wherever you can. All these guys, we want to focus on taking land with. You three come over here. That'll allow him to retreat, hopefully. Okay. Did they just kill a calf? I think they did. That's how weak they are. That's a little disappointing. Aggressive, 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 aggressive. Yeah, you can be aggressive. So even without plans, they should hopefully take over provinces. Yeah, he's just going all over the place. I didn't even tell him to do that. Oh no, he's going up that way. Okay. Alright, I think we retreat a province. Hopefully that's... he's not going to be fast enough to kill us. Because again, these divisions are very weak. You need to help out that army. Let him do the encirclement. Less than a day, it says. Okay. We are pushing in a few spots. We have free naval dockyards. Who cares? Help him out a little bit. And you are now thinking that you look okay. All right, go ahead and push. Just let him do it. Let's slightly modify his plan. You're in position. Don't worry about it. It might actually even be to our benefit that the United States landed like 10 divisions in a couple different locations, because it allows me to kill them a little bit easier. Again, I think pink is overextended. Like, I need to shorten this up. And I don't think that these two combat with cav are, I don't know. I think they're doing what I want them to do, really. Okay. Retreat to a province where we have troops. That way I know for sure you won't die. We'll give up that one province in favor of keeping these guys alive. And letting Pink relocate. I mean, he's still trying to kill this army. Let's tell him to stop. Just stop and relocate along your preferred border. He's attacking across a river. You can attack from multiple directions here. These cav and motorize could theoretically get across. Oh, we're in. No! I did it again! We're retreating! No! I hate when I do that! It's hard sometimes to tell if they're actually in combat or not. Now, if they retreat. Oh, God, thank goodness. They didn't just get annihilated instantly. They were fast enough to get there in time. Thank you. We had a sound effect. Resistance to occupation in the Panama Canal. Excuse me? United States? Right. I guess that kind of makes sense. I'm probably not going to garrison it. Okay, you're not very good at attacking, so just let him leave. I thought that these were supposed to, like, stay snapped, connected to each other, but they keep on overlapping. It's very irritating. Let's pin these troops down so that these guys can, encircle. I'm not advancing as fast as I would like, but I'm also pausing the game quite a bit. And, trying to use the AI a little bit more often. We have no deployment point, we have no equipment. A lot of these guys are saying that they don't feel strong or confident in their plan. Let's see. I mean, we do need to attack El Salvador. I think we could take half of this army. Let's take the guys that have the artillery. Should give us a big bonus. Should have a free commander. Come on down here and get ready to attack him. This is, what is this? Plains. Plains and plains. Let's have most of them go down to here, except for one of you go to here. Then we can attack from both angles on their capital. Just take that province really quickly. Okay, and we're trying to encircle a couple units here. I don't know if it's going to work. He's now trying to stop me. That's fine. Doing support attacks is expensive. One of these guys has absolutely no organization at all. Should let him get it back. We don't even have the radio. Unable to find path to target. We've got these guys ready and waiting for an opportunity to move forward, but they're kind of split up right now. I feel like I should just keep the entirety of this group force together. Because they're so easily killed that I kind of need them to have some strength in numbers. We certainly need a lot more units. Just more regular infantry, I think. Just units to hold the line. This guy's being really aggressive and attacking a lot. I want to get this war started. Okay, you will arrive in 3 hours. Okay, so I think we're ready. One more unit. 10 hours. It's another three war, world tension. Oh, great. Okay, right. So they actually got called into this war instead of it being a separate war. That's okay. I mean, we'll still be able to conquer them real quick. And then we'll have resistance to occupation most likely, but it's not a big problem. Okay, perfect scenario where I want to use motorized and stuff to just take the territory. And these guys are like really overextended now, so that's bad. If I just retreat, we don't lose organization. As long as we control this province, they should be safe. Let's take two up to there. All right. Again, pink is going nuts with his freaking border. Instead of letting purple take care of some of it. I feel like you have to constantly manage it. Like, just constantly adjust it. Treaty of San Salvador. That's curious. So even though they joined the other war, we were actually able to piece them out? That's very interesting. What happened to the other divisions? Why are you in a port? This I do not understand. You are level 3 now. Okay, that's fine. I think some of these generals are not very good. You're level 4, level 6. Okay, they've gotten a lot of experience. So, all this combat's working out for them. Modified government. Military high command, army regrouping expert. Could be cool. Panama Canal has a little bit of resistance now. Not much. I really don't care about it too much. There's not even that much down here, really. Level 3 naval base, though. So we're into October. Now, in previous runs, I hadn't even been at war with the United States at this point in the game, so I think we're kind of doing better. I would have to wager. We just have to continuously poke the army forward so that we can take over more of this terrain. We need more units. Like, I need more equipment. But we are short 388 days of infantry equipment. Despite having quite a few factories. The United States is estimated to have 13 to 17, we now have 17. So we have more military factories than they do. That's a great position to be in. Still, we need to end the war very, very fast. So somehow that has to happen. What is going on here? They're like constantly starting and stopping their engagement. Unable to find valid path to target. I wonder if we just give up this terrain. Yeah, I'd say that's probably going to be necessary at this rate. Gotta connect back up with that. We can hold out for quite a while until we run out of supplies. Until then, That engagement's not gonna go very well. Sneaky, sneaky guy. Alright, everyone stop, re-engage. Stop being a bastard. You gonna give me a, at least to give me a gap that I can poke through? That'd be nice. Gotta save these men. Okay, we've reconnected supplies. Is he just gonna let me encircle one of these guys? That'd be kinda nice of him. Seeing some advancement. Not a huge amount, but yeah, I mean the AI is doing a pretty good job. This guy feels like he can win again, so let's let him do it. Feels like there's a chance it could be a good plan. He's not sure. Okay, do we need more military youth? Probably at some point we're gonna want more manpower, so let's just get it now. Alright, losing this fight. Having them all set to aggressive, I think, might be modifying their behavior quite a bit, and maybe making them act stupid. It's quite possible. All you guys are still defending. I know you have no orders assigned, that's fine, I don't care about that. I need them to stop attacking this so that I can free up that army. The problem with these aggressive forward pushes is that the it just does wreaks havoc on the front lines. There's all kinds of crazy stuff to them. Looks like we're getting some success on the west, though. Still defending. This cav. I think we need to send over this way. Help out with the push towards Tulsa. Okay, I mean, we're doing good on speed. That's about the main thing I can say about this right now. It's only November of 38, and we're already into the war. We've conquered all of southern North America. This guy is out of supply. One of these guys will be available here in a second to kill him. Hopefully, like, instantly. 45 defense. And again, pink, like, I don't need you to cover all of this. I want you to focus on the east. Let purple take care of some of it. And purple, same thing. Stop doing that. Alright, these guys are now free. I think we go for a quick encirclement again of these two divisions. Got a nice mix, so whether it's forest or not, doesn't matter. And they're trying to pin us down, but it looks like we almost have it. Everyone that's here, just take care of this guy. It's amazing how much quicker you can do it if you just tell them all to stop and then start again. It's ridiculous. Alright, I'm gonna take a break here. I'll see you again in the next episode. As always, thank you for watching. Hopefully, this will be the final episode 4 of a new campaign, and we will just be done with, fighting the United States. So, thanks for watching, everyone. I'll see you again soon. See you in a bit.